hello. I have no idea if my mic is in adequate volume. It looks okay on my end. I actually might bump it up a little bit. Let me know how it is. It's been a while. Happy summer, everyone. It is August. The last time I streamed was in May. It was technically spring. The last time I streamed. Oh, you're probably seeing my taskbar down there, but that's okay. I'm playing in a large window that takes up most of the screen, but I still have room for the chat window, which is all that matters right now because I'm not doing the timers and the controller input and all that fancy stuff. Not just, you know, get back into it. A little practice stream. Apparently all of the Twitch servers are down except for Denver and Dallas. Like, I thought it was something on my end. I tried all of the East Coast Twitch servers and I tried all of the West Coast ones. None of them would connect. Finally, I downloaded the Twitch connection utility thing. It's not official, it's just a little tiny 50k thing that tries all the different servers, and hey, these two work, so I guess that's a thing. Hold on one sec. Yeah, I had announced the stream, not anticipating any problems, which does allow you to do a test stream, like a bandwidth test. I should have tried that first. Oh well, I'll remember that next time. So it's summer. There was a little event last month called Electronic 3. It was mostly uninteresting to me, but there was one very exciting announcement, and that was Spelunky 2. And we still don't really know anything about the game, but I am very excited. So, I thought to celebrate, I would go back for a little spelunking. And this won't be a terribly long stream because I do have to be getting to bed soon, but I thought I would just do a little, you know, a little something. I'm very rusty. It's been even longer since I played this game since I streamed, obviously, because the last stream was not this, so it stands to reason. But I'm getting my spelunking boots broken back in. It's like riding a bike. You never forget how. You might fall off if it's been a while, but that's not because you forgot, it's just because you are more uncoordinated than you used to be. I figured I would just do a little practice run and then the daily challenge, because apparently that's still going on. It's not saying my chat is connected, although my OBS is still working. Oh right, I'm doing game capture, not window capture, so you probably don't see all my other windows, no. Okay. Well, that looks good. Apologies for the unprofessionalism. I know it's very unusual for me not to be unprofessional or not to be professional. I'm trying to my chat thingy is not really doing it. It's been so long since I streamed, I don't even know if my programs work anymore. I was like, gasp, did OBS stop working when that wouldn't connect? And now my chat program Doesn't seem to be connecting, so let me just pop to my my channel here, and I will bring up the actual chat. Not that anyone's probably here, because no one's expecting me to stream, but I would like to at least know that it's working. Oh, how do I pop this thing out? I hate Twitch. Let's see. Pop out. There we go. Okay. We are popped. We have reached maximum poppage. Okay. So yeah, Spelunky 2. What's it going to be? Who knows? I have no idea. I don't think it's going to be a platformer. I don't think it's going to resemble the first game at all, mechanically. Except maybe for... I can see it being procedurally generated in some way. But I don't think it's going to be, you know, the same type of game mechanically, because I think Derek Yu realizes that the first Spelunky is pretty much a perfect 2D platformer, and you can't really iterate on it or improve it. I suppose he could make a bigger version with more levels, but I don't know if the game really needs that. So I think it's going to be aesthetically similar to the first Spelunky. It's probably still going to involve spelunking of some sort. Although maybe not in caves, which is maybe a contradiction. I bet it will involve some... Oh, right. Yeah, you die a lot in this game. I think two of my buttons are reversed, but that's okay. The microphone is not picking up the fan. It is summer. It's a bit hot. We haven't been having the same level of heat wave that they've been having in other parts of the world. But it hasn't exactly been cool and breezy here. I apologize for the noise. This is just a practice stream, everyone. No need to be upset. Okay, there we go. Alright, this should hopefully be a little bit better. Or maybe worse, who knows. Yeah, I'm glad I'm doing these practice runs before I start the daily challenge, because it would be pretty embarrassing to die on spikes on level 2 during the daily challenge. I mean, I'm a Spelunky expert. I've gotten all of the achievements. I have bested Yama on multiple occasions. I've mastered Spelunky. You know? I might not be a professional streamer, but I am a professional Spelunky player. For certain definitions of the word professional. Yeah, I wonder what was going on with the servers. It's not like there's some sort of big event going on. You know? Summer Games Done Quick is over. Ah, crud. I forget which is the bomb button and which is the row button. I want to say this is probably... Ropes? Okay, good. I probably should have launched it out. Well, I can just climb this ladder over here. Well, no, it doesn't go all the way up. Oh well. I'm going to be playing pretty conservatively for the daily challenge. I'd like to at least get to the ice caves, or whatever that world was called. It's been a while, everyone. Alright, I should probably pause because if I just let it run, the ghost might show up. Okay. So yeah, I'm thinking Spelunky 2, it might even be like a traditional roguelike. Like more of a turn-based RPG. That would be interesting. I guess it might be a platformer. I don't think it's going to be like an action platformer. Like it might be more of a Metroidvania style with not so much focus on jumping and precise action mechanics, but it might be more of like a Hollow Knight kind of situation. I guess Hollow Knight was pretty focused on precise action. I haven't played it. I've been wanting to. It's on my very long list of, not shame, you know, I don't feel ashamed of not playing games, but it's on my list of regrets. Regrets for games that I haven't played. Because, you know, there's only so much time in the day. I've been playing quite a few good games recently. I finally got into the most recent Zelda game, Zelda 9, on the Nintendo Wii U at Cutting Edge Technology, and that might be one of my new favorite games. That game is extremely good. I'm probably about a quarter-ish of the way through the game, although it's hard to tell. I've been spending a lot of time kind of wandering around and exploring because it's that kind of game. Started playing Animal Crossing again. That's a good time. Animal Crossing New Leaf, of course, not the fake phone game. Ourselves a snake pit here? Yeah, it looks like it. And this game is so easy to just jump back into. It's like I never stopped. I wonder how long it's actually been since I've played this game. I'd say at least 2 years, if not more. I have plenty of bombs, so I should probably start looking for the key. Oh yeah, this game doesn't have cloud saves, which I totally forgot about, so you're going to see a lot of journal entries pop up as I progress through the game. It's not that big a deal because none of the persistent progress in this game actually matters. But that's why I'm playing as Defaulto Spelunko and not one of the alternative characters I usually play as. Which, it's appropriate. If Spelunky 2 is about this guy's kid, then... Shit. Oh, that's going to be happening a lot. Then it's only appropriate that I play as the... Oh boy, the titular Spelunker himself. I don't know if this guy has a name in canon. Nope, that wasn't the rope button either. But yeah, it is a little bit annoying that I lost all of my characters. Okay. But it's just a cosmetic thing. Messing that one up, brain. Uh-oh. Okay. I know what to do here. I remember my ghost training. Get one of those. Grab this fella. Get a little gold, because I laugh in the face of death, and get out of there. Oh yeah, tunnel man. I never actually use these tunnels, but sure, I have enough bombs to spare one. It's been a while since I've actually listened to the music in this game as well. I usually... Ooh! Secret exit already? Nice. I usually turn it down and listen to my own... Shit. Listen to my own stuff, but, you know, for novelty purposes. Ooh! I can probably afford that jetpack. Like 20,000 something, right? Yeah, 26,000? Heck yeah. Do I want... sure. Oh yeah, I am kind of playing for score this time, aren't I? Wait, what's the buy button? Oh, right. Okay. Well, hopefully having a jetpack... Well, this isn't the actual daily challenge. This is still practice, so... I feel okay with that expenditure. Wait, is it just beeping because of this? I forget. No, because it was like... It was more up here. And I'm gonna have to... Yeah, it's like... It's like right here. Hopefully I can do this without pissing off the shopkeeper. Already? Come on, ghosty. I'm gonna have to decide for the daily challenge if I want to actually try for a Yama run or not. Oh yeah, I love this music. I forgot how good this music is. I don't like all the music in this game. Mostly it's just the first world, the mines that I have an issue with. Alright. That's like way expensive. Okay, well I guess I'm going to have to be a bit of a terrorist here. Alright, let's see if I can remember how this works. I forget if the ghost can show up in the black market or not. It's a surprising lot that I forget about this game. Alright, so I want to bomb. Might need to buy more bombs if I'm gonna pull this off. Alright, so I want to clear out this, like, the side here. Yep, that is correct. Use ropes when you have a jetpack, am I right? Like, as second nature as the mechanics of this game are for me. You know, this whole process is something that I still haven't done a whole lot in the grand scheme of things. So, yeah, I'm a lot more nervous about this than most of the other aspects of the game. Oh, apparently that unlocked the Cyclops for me. Alright, come on, friend. Oh god. Nope! Nope! Oh boy. Okay, well, that worked out somehow. Okay, that's the button. Thank you. Oh boy. Alright. Yep, that's exactly what I wanted to do. Oh boy. Okay. Oh boy. Okay, that guy's still active. Or is in the right position to do me harm. Nope. Why do I keep pressing that button? Spelunky expert, everyone. Alright. If I survive this, I will be astonished. Bombs, okay. I can afford a couple more. Alright, I think this guy is the only one left. Nope, there's more hanging out down here as well. Nope, bad timing, Mookie. Okay. Phew, okay. Well, I am astonished that I survived that. Okay, more ropes. I mean, the jetpack doesn't have infinite fuel, so it can be helpful to have ropes anyway. Hi. Okay, he dropped his gun. Thank God. Alright. Well, I am like 90% of the way to my goal of making it to the ice caves, so is going better than I thought it would, except for that first death. You know, I'm getting used to the controller. You know, this is a different controller than I'm used to playing this game with. So I can blame that. Let's see, what else can I blame? The political climate? It's got me super stressed out. I'm not performing at peak performance. Oh, this is a bad layout. The Illuminati is probably partially responsible as well, somehow. Damn it. Phew. All right. Ice caves achieved. Anything from here on out is just gravy. What crimes? That wasn't me. Shit. I mean, yeah, the other thing was me, but that one wasn't me. Alright, I don't really have to worry about the shopkeepers in the SKs because they just kind of fall to their deaths. I will have to be on the lookout for the Moai head, though. Whoa, okay. I was a little haphazard with my fuel there. Hey, doggy. Don't worry, I'll save you. It's always a little easier. Oh, this is the place. Where the magic happens. Wait, am I gonna lose my jetpack? That's gonna suck. I know I won't be able to bring the shotgun with me. I forget if the jetpack comes with me on revival or not. Alright. This guy probably won't be a threat. But even if he is, this is the best place to lose a life. Alright, anything else I want to do on this level before I face the music? Go to my eternal reward? Trip the light, fantastic. No, wait, that's something else. I guess this is pretty much it. Alright, well. Aw, man. I didn't know I had a parachute. I was gonna say I forgot I had a parachute, but I didn't actually notice picking it up. Nice that this game has a built-in timer. Oh yeah, I do keep it. Nice. Slurp. Alright, City of Gold. Oh wait. Isn't that supposed to take me to the City of Gold? Or is there another thing that I have to do? Gosh, how did I forget this? Well, that probably wasn't the smartest thing I could do, but I wanted that loot. Maybe the City of Gold comes after I finish the ice caves? I thought it would skip the last ice caves level, but maybe not. Or I guess the last two. Oh wait, no. Okay. I remember. So I got the hat. Or whatever that thing is. So that's going to be the thing that lets me kill Anubis in the next section, or it's going to... Oh boy. This is embarrassing. I can't remember. I don't remember just basic details about this game. Oops. Sorry. Oh, okay. Oh, no, you didn't. I don't think I messed up. Although killing Anubis without sticky bombs or a shotgun is going to be a challenge. Boy, I kind of breezed through the early parts of this game, and I'm starting to remember how hard the later parts are. Oh my god. I couldn't get away in time. Boy, ain't that the truth. Alright, well, I guess that's enough warm-up. Time for the daily challenge? I'm probably not ready for it yet. Although, I mean, for my second run in 2 years, I'd say that went pretty well. I'll be green lady. Alright. Time doesn't matter. Showing off doesn't matter. All that matters is that sweet, sweet, sweet dosh. Also, I forgot I don't have my jetpack anymore. Sad. But I got some ropes. That's almost like a jetpack. I'm trying to remember what the hat actually does, or whatever it is. If it's not a hat, it looks like a hat. I know it's important, but I forget in what way. Yeah, this is the music I don't like. Actually, this is probably the one track in the regular soundtrack that I'm not into, just because it sounds kind of like a corporate training video. The rest of it is pretty solid. Probably going to have to kill all the shopkeepers in the black market. I can't spend 50,000 gold on an Ankh. That's going to be just a disaster for my score. Let's see, what's the safest way down here? Probably that. Man, I should have just whipped that gold off the edge. I'm a dummy. Oh well. Well, that was too close. That was a grave mistake. I'm not quite in my grave, but that put me halfway there. Halfway to the grave. Okay. Well, that'll help a little bit. I hope the chest is down here and not like up in the top right hand corner somewhere. That would be a bummer. Yep, there it is. Nice. Nope. I'm using the Wii U Pro Controller, which I've been using a lot because of all the Zelda I've been playing, and I have to say this might be my favorite controller to use on PC, despite the incredibly convoluted process involved in getting it to work. Oh, 8,000 gold. I don't need it. That's a crutch. Who do I think I am? An amateur Spelunky player? Phew! That was close. I realized at the last second that I was close enough to trigger that thing. Man, I feel bad just using the word trigger in a normal way now because I worry that people will think that I'm using it in the internet asshole way. But I assure you, I just mean trigger in the sense of triggering a trap, not like, oh, I pissed that trap off. Is a triggered snowflake? Yeah, that's not what I mean. And I hope it doesn't come across that way. Let's see here. Ooh, didn't see you. Alright, gotta be a little careful here. These barrels could blow up at the slightest provocation. You know, I was looking through my stats and I realized I haven't even broken 1 million points in this game. My high score is only like 500 some thousand. So, as far as Spelunky experts go, I'm probably in one of the lower tiers. I mean, I'm still an expert, don't get me wrong. I'm not some noob, but I am not a grandmaster expert, which is fine. I never needed to be that. Whoa. Ooh, was that an altar over there? I think it might have been. Nope, just an ordinary step. Okay. It's kind of altar-shaped. I still don't know if it's altar or altar. I feel like I'm too close to the mic. I hope I'm not clipping or blown out. I really should have recorded a test stream, but when you haven't streamed in 3 months, or I guess 2.5-ish, it was about the end of May when I streamed, so it's been about 2 months. 2 months and change. Not really a big fan of this music either, I guess. It's a little too unstructured for my taste. Not bad. It's just not my thing. Not worth trying for. It's a valuable gem, but not so valuable to expose myself to the risk of carnivorous plantitude. That's a bad enemy to get there. At least I'm remembering the fundamentals. You know, never whip pots. Always be carrying, although always be carrying isn't as big a deal anymore now that I have arrow whip tech. Alright, I think that these are pretty easy to get, yeah. That's gonna be a big boon to my high score. Big Ed Boon. This corner? Sure looks like this corner. Let's see if I can take out this statue. Little two birds with one stone. Yep, this is it. Alright, I'm not gonna have too many bombs going into this, so So hopefully there will be at least some for sale. Oh, well, that's some bombs. Alright, 15,000. Yeah, this is a necessary investment. Shit. Well, that's probably fine. I'm probably going to want a rope there. Alright. Do I want to do anything else down here? I'd say probably not. Alright. Here goes. I left myself cover this time, which I think I forgot to do last time. Which would be helpful for drawing them out of there. I should probably throw another rope down here as well. Well, maybe not. Come on. This way. Come on. Oh god. Okay. Sometimes you do have to whip pots. It's not accurate to say never, but only in the most extreme circumstances. Alright, let's throw this down. I'm still alive. Although, a little deeper now. Wait, is he still alive? No, okay. Oh god. That was a big risk, but a big reward. Oh, how did I forget how good this game is? This game is so good. I suppose I should have anticipated that. Alright, well that's okay. I'm still in the game. EA Sports, I'm in the game. I only have two ropes, so I'm going to have to... Actually, let's see if I can get the ghost down here. And then I will... loop back around. Okay, so I won't be doing a Yama run, which that should be expected really for a daily challenge. You don't really want to do a Yama run at all necessarily. Crap. Alright, this is going to be... Oh, this is bad. I wish I could look down. I suppose I can, just not while I'm hanging on the ropes. Fudge, fudge, fudge. Okay. Rope. Okay, still in the game. I could still break 200k easily. Sure, I won't get the City of Gold. This isn't going to be a record-breaking run. But I think this is pretty good for return after a long absence. I wonder if there's something else I can call that instead of an altar, just so I can avoid having to say the word altogether. What are some other terms for a religious thing or spiritual thing that you put things on? Pedestal, maybe? Doesn't quite have the same weight, but it might be an alternative word I can use. Ooh, this sucks. Okay, this doesn't suck so bad. I probably should be actually trying to get more money instead of just speeding through like this. Kind of forgot my goal here. Alright, so ice caves with no jetpack, no cape, no mobility. No, that's okay. We don't need no credit card to ride this train. All we need is the power of love. And shotgun shells. Some poor soul is caught in an infinite jump loop down there. Uh-oh. Oh yeah, I don't have any ropes either. Oh boy. I really boned this up, didn't I? I forgot that you can get into these unwinnable situations if you blow through all of your resources. So what are some... Maybe I can... Okay, this is crazy. Maybe I can kill myself with a bomb? No. Okay. Here's a thought. I can blow that up. Blow up the pedestal. Well, never mind. Make spiders come out. I probably should have just used the Yeti, because I've never been good at cooking bombs. And then jump off the spider over to the right. I misoverestimated my abilities. Oh god. Nope. Oh, so close. And yet so far away. Alright, let's see how I did. Number 147. Well, could be worse. I wonder how many people actually played here. I forget, is there any way to do this other than just scrolling all the way to the bottom? More people playing than I anticipated. For how old this game is and how it's not really in the zeitgeist anymore and like the speedrunning community. Quite a few people still playing this. I mean, I shouldn't be surprised. It's a fantastic game. How do I... I am 3,080 in the all-time leaderboards. 9,038 on the high score list, which isn't horrible. Top 10,000, that's something. Ooh. Top 2,000 as far as fastest times. I wonder who has the official Spelunky speedrun record. Can I use my mouse to, like, rapidly scroll up? I guess not. I'm sure whoever's at the top, well, at least this is quieter than using the controller. I'm sure whoever at the top has, like, 1 second somehow just by exploiting some sort of system. Yeah, even that's going to take way too long. I seem to remember there being a faster way to just jump to the top. But I guess not. Like, how do I change this filter? Oh, I mean, I guess I can just click on it. Oh, there we go. I don't know how I changed that without using the mouse. None of the buttons seem to be doing what I want them to do, but oh well. Alright, so congratulations to Malungo for a quite impressive high score. Yeah. 0.000 seconds. I wonder how far down the first real one is. Okay, here we go. 2 seconds. So my time is like 5 minutes or something. Yeah, I'd say a minute 40 something is in the realm of possibility. Yeah, I haven't actually been keeping up with the speedrun community. I did for a while. There's some pretty interesting stuff. Oh, I shouldn't just be indiscriminately scrolling through Steam names. What's wrong with me? This is a bad idea. Or just wondering if there was anyone I recognized on here. Oh, there we go. Bananasaurus Rex. I know that guy. Well, I don't know him. I've heard of him. Let's see. Is Yummy Yama Ding Dong on here? He might have changed his Steam name. Oh, well. This has been, this wrong button. Yep. This has been the wrong button again. This has been the Spelunky Daily Challenge. Thank you for watching, and I will see you soon, maybe. Hopefully. Take care. Goodbye.